Everybody, I'm Chip.
And I'm Chris.
And we're the Löw Tide Böyz.
Today we're going to be talking about the Tether. What is it, how you make one, and why you should be using it. So first, what is it? So the Tether is essentially a piece of cord, paracord, or some sort of webbing that you use to attach to your partner in a swim run. Pretty crazy, but it's honestly a huge advantage, and we highly recommend people doing it, not just for safety, but for having a more fun experience during your swim run. Now Chipper's going to tell you about how do you make one of these things.
So we have a whole separate video on this as well, but for the quick hits of it, a tether is supposed to be 3 meters long, which is 10 feet for our US folks. So when you're making your tether, I always cut off an extra foot or two just to have around, and you need 2 carabiners to tie it on, a couple anchor knots, and you're good to go. Another good way to measure to make sure that it's long enough is you and your partner lay down, one person clips on and the other person, yep. And to make sure that you have enough when you're fully out for your stroke.
Yeah, and there's a couple different ways to attach the tether. So you can either attach it to your wetsuit. Some wetsuits have a loop where you can just attach it right there, or you can attach it to your pull buoy mount if you're using a waist mount, or you can get one of these handy dandy belts you can wear around your waist. This one has an incorporated little loop to it, so it's nice and secure, and then you don't have to worry about, you know, having it go haywire on you. Now, why do you want to use a tether? Well, basically, it makes you faster. Not only do you stay in contact, you're able to stay in your draft zone behind the person you're swimming with, your partner, but when you're running, you actually get like real-time haptic feedback. Whoever's leading the runs, letting you know exactly how your partner's doing pace-wise, and you can actually help your partner if someone's struggling. That literally pull someone up a hill if needed.
We like to keep tethered on the entire race. So that's how we do it. Work for whatever works with you, but we recommend trying to go as long as you can.
And obviously you should always be communicating with your partner, but you know, that unspoken communication you can have by having real-time haptic feedback with the tether is really helpful. Now, you wanna make sure the tether is the right length for you and your partner. So we recommend, once you cut it to length, making sure that you lie down with one partner leading in front and one in the back, so you make sure that it's short enough so you're close enough to your partner in the swims, so you're in the draft zone, but not too short that you're, you know, hitting your partner's feet and not being able to have a good stroke. So if it is too long, we came up with this handy little thing.
If you're in the middle of a race and your tether's too long and it's annoying you, you can easily take a little bit of bite out of the tether and do a quick little knot like that, and there we just ate off 6 to 8 inches worth of tether and really shorten that up.
Right.
And you can even undo it after.
If that's too long, you can just put one little easy knot in it. If you're just trying to dial it in just right. As you can see, this is our tether that we've used. But we had to adjust on the fly, but you know, we knew to do this and it worked really great. So that's the tether. Check out the Löw Tide Böyz, the Swimrun podcast. Go to lowtideböyz.com to get more information and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
See you out there. Razzle dazzle.